Oh, you can feel it, can't you? You sit up a little bit straighter.
Yeah.
And the Queen is going to be front and centre, of course, later this week as preparations for her Platinum Jubilee celebrations ramp up.
I'm looking forward to this. Live now to Europe correspondent Brett McLeod, who's across it all. Only a couple of days to go before the big party begins. It'll be massive, Brett. Mm.
These could be Britain's biggest ever party, Carl and Ali. Good morning. The final preparations are underway. And, of course, the woman this is all about is back at Windsor Castle. Now, she is more mobile now than we've seen her in months. For a long time, we didn't see her at all. But now we've seen her a lot in the past few days, which is a sign of her health really being quite good. She flew back from Aberdeen Airport today. She'd been staying at Balmoral and then went straight to Windsor Castle for the final preparations before, in roughly 36 hours, the beginning of 4 days of celebrations for her Platinum Jubilee, of course, the first monarch to do that. Now, part of that is Buckingham Palace itself has had a big rejuvenation during lockdowns, during COVID. So the picture gallery has been reframed. Out the front, they've made a lot of preparations for the tens of thousands of people expected to line the Mall and also visit the front of Buckingham Palace during those days of celebrations. We've seen the final rehearsals where you see hundreds of people on horseback. There'll be over 1,000 troops taking part in the parade. Up to about 1,000 commands each are going to be given to this particular parade. And then finally, of course, at Windsor Castle itself, we're seeing a lot of the souvenirs that you'd expect during the Queen's reign. Well, they're going off as people go to get their one moment to remember this moment in history, which who knows if we'll ever see anything quite like this again in Britain.
Brilliant.